Hey you! Have you ever been jump scared by this guy? How about one of these? Well, I've just the thing for you. Introducing the Huggy Dissection Kit from Playtime Go. Now you can...
Hold on. Let's pause the commercial real quick. Spice Marketing speaking? What do you mean we can't sell this? Children love these kind of things. What was that? Dead children? Orphans? And playing people into toy... Don't make me call Leif Pierre. He would totally agree with me. Alright, see you. Well, if we can't sell this Huggy Dissection Kit, then I'll just have to bring that dissection kit to you. After all, in the world of Playtime Co., we know it isn't as simple as just shoving a body into a vessel. No, no, no. There is a science here. One that I think I have a pretty decent concept for. You see, there are a lot of anomalies that show this thing doesn't just have a human skeleton with human organs, but rather its own specialty made and grown biology. So sit back and relax as I go over a full deep dive on the biological makeup of a fictional monster made of depressed orphans who hasn't touched any grass since 1997. Now then, let's dissect a Huggy. For this video, I've made a diagram. Now, there's a lot of stuff, so I'll be going through each thing of note in chunks, show how I came to that conclusion, then we'll add it to our friendly diagram, Huggy. We'll call him Dougie. Let's start with the arms. Huggy's arms have always been notably bendy. They can fold, twist, and do all sorts of things. This is most apparent in the vent chase, where his legs and arms bend at odd angles as he contorts himself through the vents. There's also this moment where it slinks away behind a door in a snake-like motion. From this, we can pretty clearly see that Huggy doesn't have any bones in his arms or legs. But if so, what are his limbs made of? His control of it means there definitely has to be some meat in there juicing around. In my opinion, I think it's something like this. We have a segmented chain of cartilage, which is covered in muscle tissue. This in turn would allow it to be moved around rather loosely and easily bend and contort like we see in game. The only exception is his hand, which although is also composed of muscle and cartilage, Huggy has at least two bones in his hand, one in his palm and one or more shaping the thumb. I chose to add this because in an animation scene in Project Playtime's monster menu, when choosing Huggy, he bangs his hands on the screen. During this, he clenches his hands into fists, which would be rather difficult without bones in them. So to keep it minimal and accurate, I have only included those bones, though he may have more depending on how well he can shape his hands. I also think it's pretty clear that Huggy has foot bones, as not only are his steps not very wobbly, but his feet are consistently flat. His feet also have three distinct toes. Oh god, I really am becoming MatPat! And a dew claw in the back. A dew claw is basically a foot thumb seen in things like dogs to help him pin things down. Though of course, with an arm made almost entirely out of muscle, he'd need a lot of blood flow, and for that, he'd need a big heart. When you exercise, your muscles are gonna need a lot of oxygen, and to get that oxygen, you're gonna need a good amount of blood, so that way when you're, dashing through vents at full speed towards a yellow spoon man, you don't get dizzy, you're tired, or have to slow down. So from this we can gather that Huggy has a big heart, but with all this extra blood you're gonna need bigger veins to get it where it needs to go. I guess Garten of Banbail was right about something.
Why are you so veiny?
Oh, here's an interesting one. Throughout each of Huggy's appearances, we don't really see or hear breathing, especially seeing as when he's still and pretending to be a statue, his chest doesn't move. Now, was this a minor detail that they knew literally nobody would care about and thus didn't feel the need to add? Maybe. But let's analyze it anyways, because the conclusion is actually really interesting. You see, when you breathe, the reason your chest moves up and down is because of the diaphragm. When it contracts, there's negative pressure in the chest which pulls the lungs open and allows air inside. When it relaxes, the lungs contract and the air moves out, thus allowing you to breathe. However, there's a particular animal that notably doesn't have a diaphragm. The tortoise. Okay, hear me out. You see, the diaphragm moves with the ribs. However, the rib cage of a tortoise is fused with their shells. So rather than having a diaphragm, tortoises have a different muscle around the lungs that expand and contract automatically in a way that isn't visible. Seeing as Huggy's chest doesn't rise and fall, meaning he doesn't have a diaphragm, Huggy likely has a muscle like this too, which expands and contracts separate from the rib cage. So basically, Huggy has tortoise lungs. The only thing is I don't really know where to put this on the diagram, so I'm just gonna put it like right here. Don't yell at me due to the fact that it's still in the rib cage. Where else would you put it? You want me to put it in like the arms or something? Now, Huggy is often referenced as a security guard and was placed right at the entrance to take care of intruders. So naturally, he has a lot of biological enhancements to make this as easy as possible. It seems like although he may chew little, Huggy for the most part will swallow the bodies whole. As in both his and his mini variations jump scares, it stretches their mouth over the entire screen, which implies they're unhinging their jaw. To further support this, Huggy has no tongue, which is really surprising, as as most of the Playtime Co. cartoon versions depict him as having one. However, if you look at the jump scares, he doesn't. Without a tongue, pushing smaller amounts of food deep enough to swallow would be absurdly difficult. However, larger food sources, like a person, could be pushed in, and the weight would allow the rest of it to go down relatively easy. The teeth are likely to ensure that the chosen prey is dead and or fatally injured before being forced inside, as a struggle may make swallowing more difficult. But just to clarify, he does chew. We see him do it in some of the trailers. I suspect the ribs are slightly segmented too, so it can still keep flat even when somebody's inside. That way, if Huggy had eaten somebody before the place opened, they wouldn't have to scramble to explain away why there's an obvious indent of a person inside him. By having some segments of cartilage, the stomach has a bit of wiggle room to expand a little and fit the host while keeping a flat shape. It would also likely have its own layer of muscle to further keep the stomach consistently flat, regardless of if he'd eaten or not. Due to Huggy having no clear exit point, we'll also have to think about where it goes. After all, we know that these toys do eat, but if there's no exit point, then that only leaves one place for the remnants to leave. But also wouldn't be ideal to vomit every single time you're finished with one body, especially if you have more than one in a given period of time. Let's look at owls. Owls have an organ called the gizzard. Anything that an owl can't break down, such as teeth, skulls, and feathers, are compacted into a tight pellet that the owl regurgitates. This process is done even when other things are still digesting, and without it, their insides could be damaged by the sharp remnants of what they'd eaten. Back to Huggy. If Huggy can't properly spit up the bones or any other dangerous material a person might have on them, like belt buckles or keys, this may cause tears in their stomach, which is especially bad given that their skin is fabric. So Wuggies as a species would likely have a gizzard of their own to prevent this from happening. Let's have it here attached to the stomach. You may also notice that there's no intestines, going straight to the stomach sac. This is because, like I said before, the lack of tongue makes it hard to eat smaller things. If he had intestines before the stomach, a person wouldn't fit. And he can't have the intestines after the stomach because he needs to spit out a pellet later, and having it stuck in a winding tomb would be pretty problematic. Huggy's skull is the same shape as his head, with holes for eyes, but for reasons stated before about swallowing things whole, I based the under jaw off of a snake's skull. That's why it has this sort of hingy part on the back of the jaw, and why it separates in the center here. Another interesting thing is his second set of teeth. When he jump scares you, you can see another set at the back of the throat. This appears to be a pharyngeal jaw. Essentially, there's a second jaw in the throat attached to the spine that is folded up sort of like this. When the creature opens its mouth, it flexes the muscle, allowing it to act as a second set of teeth to grab and force food deeper like a set of tongs. Pharyngeal jaws are most well known as part of the moray eel. And with that, let's look at Huggy's diagram one last time. In summary, Huggies sport a chain of cartilage in their arms, allowing them to bend and contort in the way they do in game. He has a big heart. Due to not having a diaphragm, his lungs are wrapped in muscle to make him breathe automatically. He has a gizzard, so dangerous items can be compacted into a pellet-like form and then spit out. And lastly, Huggy has a pharyngeal jaw at the back of his throat. So what are your thoughts on all of this? Do you disagree with any of my points or ideas? And most importantly, what do you think of my dissection? This was Spice from CutCafe, and I'll see you around. Peace! Welcome to the update corner. For those of you who watched to the end, I just wanted to give an update on that whole story-driven project I was referencing in a community post a while back. It's a Poppy Playtime miniseries I've been working really hard on. I'll be making an announcement video once it's close to completion, but as of recording this, I'm hoping to maybe get something out of it by the end of March. No promises though. It's gonna have lots of cool stuff, lots of extra lore, foreshadowing, and hidden secrets, and even some new faces, so look forward to an announcement at some point, probably sometime in March. I've already finished 3 of the 12 scripts and fully set up sets and character designs for it. Anyways, thanks for listening to my rambling. I've been struggling for a bit, seeing as my monetization was cut for the last 2 weeks, and I couldn't get any of the money for my Ollie video or my Pochi video, which really sucked because it means I lost over $200. But I got it fixed now, so if you made it to this end part, comment something about, I don't know, cheese. Comment your favorite cheese down below. Thank you, you're the best. Bye-bye!